Okay, this is another edition of our famous function series of lectures. This will probably be the second most famous function in our BCS Pola functions, and it's polynomials. And polynomials, of course, you probably recall, are of the form, say for example here, negative 6 x to the seventh minus 8 x to the fifth, plus 7x to the fourth, plus 3.23 pi x to the ninth, and so on here, minus 4x plus 83. Okay, whatever here. The main thing here is that we're adding and subtracting here values of powers of x, integral powers of x, or not even integral powers of x, but rather whole number powers of x, including x to the zero here, and with real number coefficients in front of them being multiplied there. Why are these so important? Well, it turns out here's two reasons. First of all, going way back to elementary school, if we took this function, say g of x is 6x to the fifth, plus 7x to the third, plus 2x squared, plus 8x, plus 9, and I ask you, plug in 10, and I'll give you 2 seconds to figure out what the answer is. Well, that should be an easy question, because what we get here is 6 times 10 to the fifth. That's 600,000, plus 0, 10 to the fourth, plus 7, 10 to the third, plus 2 times 10 squared, so that's 200. 8 times 10 is 80, and we have plus 9. And so our place value really here, or our polynomial, is really a generalization of our place value system, where we have the ones place, the constants place, the tens place, how many tens do we have? How many 10 squares do we have? How many 10 cubes do we have? And so on here. One, and perhaps it was a historically a motivation for this, or at least the emergence of polynomials as a major player in algebra and in mathematics in general, was that it modeled our place value system, the Hindu-Arabic system. Now, going forward, in terms of this beyond calculus, or at least within calculus that you'll see, is that polynomials are very nicely behaved functions. You learn back in algebra or pre-calculus that they are very nicely behaved. For example, we know because, say, g of x here, the fifth power, is a fifth degree polynomial, we will have at most five real roots for that polynomial. We can predict that. Or we could have at most four humps on the polynomial when we try to graph it in terms of peaks and valleys of the polynomial. We would have exactly five real and complex roots put together in that polynomial. So they're very smooth graphs. They're very well behaved. And they also, in terms of the arithmetic here, only use the four or five basic operations that we talk about: addition and subtraction. We have multiplication here. We have exponentiation going on as well. We also have a bit of division and some other things going on with irrational or rational numbers here for the coefficients. And so they're very nice arithmetically to say program on a calculator or a computer, and they're very nice and predictable. And as it turns out, you could be able to write most functions, as you'll find out when you study something called Taylor series a little bit later on, is that you'll be able to write and approximate other functions, non-polynomial functions, as polynomials, making the work on the computer much easier to calculate or to approximate values here. So for example, e to the x, probably the most famous one here, can be written starting with the constant and then working up here, 1 plus x plus 1 half x squared plus 1 6x cubed plus 1 24th x to the fourth. And if you continue on forever there, and especially for values of x near 0 here, this polynomial is an excellent approximator of e to the x without having to do any exponentials at all, except for dealing with whole number powers here and nice fractions and addition and maybe some subtraction too, although not in this particular case. So it turns out polynomials were very, very important for place value way back when in your education here. And then hopefully in the future of your education here, you're going to also see them pop up as good approximators of other functions. One other note here is you'll notice if we just have a first degree term and or a constant term there, we get a linear function. And so linear functions are special cases of polynomials. In fact, later on in this course, you'll be trying to approximate other functions by not complete polynomials here, but say by cutting off the linear ones here, and we would get e to the x equal to 1, approximately equal to 1 plus x, turns out, for x values near 0, and we would call this the linear approximation. You'll see how to do that a bit later on in the semester, and you'll extend that to Taylor series a little bit later on in the calculus sequence.